in the book, the next part is given as the force and motion. Already you had studied the force and motion, force and motion in 9th standard and 8th standard. Here once again we will take the revision of that. What is force? The push or pull that changes or tends to change the state of rest or uniform motion. And its SI unit is Newton and its CGS unit is time. What is force? It is a phenomenon that push or pull, that type of push or pull changes or tends to change the body which is at rest, that is set into motion, or the body which is in the state of uniform motion, that can be that that position of motion can be stopped. What is motion? Movement of any object from one position to another position with respect to observer is called as motion. Example, any moving body, like here I had given it as any moving car. Now let me see the new concept from this lesson, circular motion and centripetal force. Now circular motion, you already know that. What is circular motion? The movement or motion of any body on a circular path. Movement or motion of any body on a circular path is called as circular motion. It is called as the circular motion. How we are performing the circular motion? Suppose there is a playground, circular playground, and you are playing a bicycle here, or you are running from this point to this point. This you are performing. This you are moving. Your motion is from this starting point and you are going once again to the same point. That motion is called as circular motion. Now the next part, centripetal force. What is centripetal force? Center seeking, the centripetal force, the force which is towards center, the force which is seeking towards center is called as a centripetal force. A force acts on any object moving along a circle and it is directed towards the center of circle. Now already we have taken what is circular path. Now let me see the same example. You are moving or you are running with your bicycle or with your legs. You are moving from this A point and once again you are reaching to the same point. That is, you are in a circular motion. Your body or your bicycle is performing on a circular motion. You are following the circular path. Now the force which, now here when you are moving on this circular path, some force is acting on your body, and the force which is directed towards the center of circle, that force is called as the centripetal force. The force acts on any object moving along a circle. It is directed towards the center of circle. That is called as the centripetal force. Suppose you are taking a long string or a long thread and you tied a stone towards the one end of that thread and you are moving that thread with your hand. Then the force, you are moving your hand in this circular motion. Then whatever the force is acting on that string, on that stone, that is called as the centripetal force. Now let me take an example to explain the centripetal force. Already you know that definition. Suppose I am taking a string and any body I am tying to the one end of that string. Suppose here I had taken the string, the thread, and I had tied a chalk to one end of this thread. Okay, now the force, whenever I am moving this, thread in a circular motion, then whatever the force is acting on this chalk, that is called as a centripetal force. Let me take this example here. Okay, here I am moving the thread with my hand in this circular motion. Here you can observe that, the chalk is moving, performing a circular motion with help of that string. And now that force acting on that body, acting on that chalk, is the centripetal force. Now let me take the answers of these some questions which are also given in the book. Are we applying the force on a chalk here? Are we applying a force on a chalk? Yes, we are applying the force on this chalk. In which direction this force is acting? This force is acting towards its circular center of this circular path. Yes, the force is acting towards the center of that circle. How will you stop this force acting? We can stop this force acting on that chalk by stopping our hand, by stopping that circular motion. And what will effect on that on the chalk when we stop that force? Suppose here I had stopped that force by removing the circular motion of that thread. What will happen? You can observe here where the chalk had gone. The chalk goes in the direction in which we had stopped the motion. Suppose here I am moving that stone. Here I had taken the string and the chalk is tied to one end of this string, and I started circular motion of that, moving this chalk in a, with help of thread, in a circular motion. Now the force acting on this chalk is towards the center of this circle. That is called as a centripetal force. And how can we stop the force acting on this chalk? I can stop its motion. I can stop that moving of that thread so that the force on that body will stop. Now, what will happen if I stop that force? When I will stop that force, I will remove the force applying with that thread. So, when I remove that thread, whatever the motion, whatever the direction of motion is on that chalk, the chalk falls in the same direction. Suppose the chalk is moving to this direction, okay, and I stop or I remove my hand on that thread, the chalk will move. Here is the chalk. Now, the chalk will move in the same direction. Suppose the chalk is here in this part, the chalk is moving towards this part. It is moving towards this line and I stop the force here. I stop the force acting on this chalk, that or I remove my hand from that thread. Then the chalk will go in this direction. This is centripetal force. What is centripetal force? The force acting on any body which is performing the circular motion, which is center seeking force, that force is called as a centripetal force. Now let me go for the deep studies of the centripetal force. As you observe, what is centripetal force? The center seeking force is called as a centripetal force on the body which is moving in a circular path. Here we know that the earth is there in the universe and the moon is revolving around our earth. The moon here is performing the circular motion around our earth. Now, is the same force is acting on the moon? Yes, the same force of centripetal force is acting on the moon. Some questions given here are in the book. Moon, which is a natural satellite of Earth, goes round in a definite orbit. The direction of motion as well as its speed is constantly changing during this motion. Do you think the same force acting on that body? Yes, the force is acting on that moon also. The next question is that, what must be the direction of this force? What is the direction of this force? The direction of this force, that is moon, is performing the circular motion. So, force on that moon is directed towards the center of that earth. That is the centripetal force. Now, the next question is that, how would its motion have been if no such force acting on it? Okay, if no such force is exerted by our earth on that moon, that is no centripetal force is acting on this moon. Now, what will happen to the motion of moon? The moon will never be attached. The moon will never will be performed. The moon will never perform the circular motion around the earth. But instead, the moon will move in any another direction, that is away from earth. But this is never happened in universe. Moon always revolves around the earth as the earth is attracting to the the earth is exerting some force on that moon. As if the moon is revolving in a circular path, the moon is having the centripetal force on it. Next question is that, do other planets in the solar system revolve around the sun in the similar fashion? Here I had shown the diagram here. The sun is there. You know the diagram of universe. The sun is in the center of universe. And the other planets like the Mars, the Earth, the revolving moon, the Neptune, Uranus, all the planets are moving around the sun. The question is that, do the same force is acting on these planets? Yes, the same force is acting on these planets as all the planets are moving in a circular orbits around the sun. Next question is that, is a similar force acting on them? Yes, the similar force, that is the centripetal force acting on their body. What must be its direction? Quite natural. The direction is towards the center of sun. That is directed towards the force is directed towards the sun. Okay. From the above activity, example and questions, it is clear that for the moon to go around the earth, there must be a force which is exerted on the moon. And this force must be exerted by the earth, which attracts the moon towards itself. Similarly, the sun must be attracting the planet, including the earth, towards itself. So, this is easy concept of centripetal force. Hope you understood very well. Thank you.